Welcome to the Family Devotional. Brought to you by Children Can. Welcome back and thank you for joining us. Lizzie was driving in her car on her way to see her auntie. Auntie Nice Nice was Lizzie's favourite aunt. Her real name wasn't Nice Nice, but when Lizzie was only 2 years old, she had called her that and the name had stuck. Yeah. Now, everybody called her that and nobody could really remember what Auntie Nice Nice's name actually was. Anyway, where were we? Oh yes, Lizzie was driving in a car on her way to see her auntie. It was quite a long drive and Lizzie was busy thinking about all the fun things she was going to do, all the nice food she was going to eat and all the stories they were going to share together. Lizzie was not thinking about how much petrol she had in the car. This was a shame because if she had thought about it, she would have had time to get more fuel before it ran out. As it was, she didn't notice and the car stopped. It was on that day that Lizzie realised how important fuel is. If there's no fuel going around the engine, then the engine won't go around. And if the engine doesn't go, then the car doesn't go either. Disaster! The life of the car is in the fuel, Lizzie thought, as she waited for someone to come and help her. And that was a great way to think. Of course, we have life in us too. The Bible tells us that that life was put there by God. He breathed his life into us. The Bible also tells us that our life is found in the blood. When we look at the Old Testament, we see that God told the Israelites to sacrifice animals to him. When the blood came out of the animals, it was like their life was leaving them. They gave up life so that the Israelites would not have to die for their sins. God was saying, I'll accept their life instead of yours. You deserve to die, but I want you to live. Of course, this was not a permanent replacement, so the Israelites had to keep on making sacrifices as they kept on sinning. All the Israelites had to do was admit that they had sin and bring their sacrifice to God.
Excuse me, but this has all got very serious.
Well, it is a very serious thing.
Well, would you mind telling some jokes to lighten things up a bit?
Sure, why not? Knock, knock. Who's there? Cargo. Cargo who? Cargo, toot, toot, vroom, vroom. What animal can you always find at a baseball game?
I don't know. What animal can you always find at a baseball game?
A bat. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Cows go.
Cows go who?
No, silly. Cows go moo.
Knock, knock. Who's there?
Owls go.
Owls go who?
Yes, owls go to whoo. Which hand is it better to write with?
I'm not sure. Is it the right hand?
No, neither. It's better to write with a pencil.
They were great. Now you can carry on telling us about those sacrifices.
Well, thank you. The Bible tells us in Colossians chapter 2, verse 17, in the past, these things were like a shadow of what was to come. But the new things that were coming are found in Christ. The animal sacrifices all pointed to the big sacrifice that Jesus was going to make on the cross. They were like a shadow, giving the outline of what was going to happen, but without the details. When Jesus's blood came pouring out of him on the cross, he was giving his life. But this sacrifice was the real thing. It would never have to be repeated ever again, but would have power over sin, sickness, and death forever. When Jesus died on the cross, the blood came pouring out of him. He was giving up his life so that we could live. Jesus swapped his life for ours. And all we have to do is admit that we have sinned and come to God through Jesus. Have you ever done that? Have you ever asked Jesus to take away your sin? Have you ever chosen and decided to follow God? If not, why don't you do it today? As soon as this devotional ends, ask someone to pray with you, perhaps your parents. Your prayer might go something like this. Dear God, thank you that you love me. You know that I have sinned and not lived as you made me to. I have messed up. Thank you that you allowed Jesus' life to be messed up when he died on the cross so that we could swap places. that he would take my sin and I would be forgiven. I believe that you are God, and I choose to accept the swap that you have done for me. I choose to live my life for you today, tomorrow, and for the rest of my life. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Hey, if you prayed that prayer, make sure you tell someone in your family about the decision you made today. And I'd love to hear about it too, so get in touch. That's all for now. Until next time, bye.
This production was made by Children Can. To find out more about us, go to www.childrencan.co.uk.